back then they napped on me. Now they all just act on me. Now I'm hot, they all on me. Pull out the Snapchats on me. I ain't got no Snapchat, homie. I think it's too personal. That's what I got Twitter for. Instagram, I'm not your
like flex on you haters. Hi haters. This is my world.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am going to be doing a video talking about my 2 pregnancies and 2 C-sections that I had. So I am going to be looking at my notepad. I took notes just because I wanted the video to flow and I didn't want to just ramble. So I do have some points that I'm going to hit in this video, and then at the end I'll give you guys some advice, some tips, things like that about if you're, you know, a new mom, if you're about to have a baby, if you're currently pregnant, and then also if you are having a C-section like I did. So if this is something that you are interested in and you want to see, go ahead and stick around and it will be great. So I'm going to start from the beginning. I am a mom of 2 and I did have 2 C-sections, of course. So my first C-section, I was due I was due between August the 24th and August 26th. I don't remember exactly the day, but somewhere around there. I had my son on August the 11th, 2015, which makes him 2. I had him in Louisiana, northern Louisiana, because I was currently going to school there. The reason why I had the C-section was just because of some health issues and complications, and it was better for me and him to go ahead and have that C-section. So I was a little bit nervous, just because, first of all, I never wanted to have kids just because of the fear of childbirth and pregnancy and things like that. So at that point, I had already went through the pregnancy and I'm like, girl, you gotta have this baby. Like, how am I gonna get through with this? So I went in for my doctor's appointment and I believe that that was a Wednesday when I went in for my doctor's appointment. I went in, the doctor was like, we're just gonna go ahead and take them, and on that next Tuesday, I was gonna have them. So that was less than a week for me to prepare. I packed my bag August the 1st with him. So all of that was prepared, but we didn't sterilize the bottles. We didn't like get all his clothes together, like sort his clothes, wash them and things like that. So me and my best friend were like chickens with our heads cut off, trying to make sure everything was ready and prepared for my son's actual surgery. With my son, it was easy. The actual procedure was easy. I didn't feel anything, but during the C-section, I felt like I was going to puke my insides up. I really was like, yo, I have to throw up. They gave me a little pan. They put it right next to my face like this. And I'm laying down. If you ever watch videos or anything like that, you're laid out in a T and your arms are strapped sometimes. The first one, my arms were strapped. The second one, my arms weren't strapped, but I had to keep them down in these little weights. I was laying on my back. They put the pan right here. So all I was able to do was this. That was not gonna work for me. So I'm like, you guys, I cannot do this. I need to throw up. They didn't announce like, congratulations, your baby was born or anything like that. They literally said 1338. So that's when FediWap had just became popular. So I'm thinking like, they thinking of a song? No, it's 1738. Like what? So then about 2 to 3 minutes later, I hear a baby crying. but the baby was behind me. So I turned around and I'm like, oh, so y'all wasn't gonna let me know my job was here? Like, on the videos that I watched, they made an announcement like, congratulations, your baby was born, or it's a boy, stuff like that. They didn't do that with me. I do want to pause here and say, if you are extremely nervous, do not watch any videos of childbirth or C-sections, because it might scare you, and each pregnancy, each C-section is different. Now I'm giving you guys my experience. Your experience may be totally different. Back to it. So, fast forward my recovery. They did do a spinal tap. I forgot to mention that with both of them. I did have a spinal tap. With my son, the spinal tap was like burning. It stung when they first did it. And then after that, I was fine. And it worked like this with both. But the recovery, I went into this room right after. It took them about maybe 20 minutes to stitch me up. I went into this room right after where I was able to hold my son and things like that. And then they pushed the bed that I was in into my room. I had already put my stuff in that room prior to going back for my C-section. So everything was in there. Oh, I was in the hospital with my son from Tuesday to Friday. On Tuesday, that's when I had him, I had a catheter. Wednesday morning, when they did their shift change, they took that catheter out, honey. They were like, you have to get up, you have to walk, you have to go to the bathroom by yourself. And this might sound nasty, but every time I got up to go to the bathroom, literally it was chunks of blood coming out. Like, I was freaking out because I don't do blood. So my best friend helped clean it up and stuff like that. So shout out to her, because I don't do blood and I was about to puke just looking at it. So Thursday, still had to walk by myself. I did a few laps around Wednesday and Thursday, and then we went home about 12 on Friday. It was so hard for me to walk. You really don't know that you use your stomach muscles that much doing simple things. Like, I couldn't laugh, I couldn't sneeze, I couldn't sit up by myself. Like, it took me literally 20 minutes to go 5 feet to the bathroom. Like, it was horrific. So with my daughter, my due date with her was January 28th, 2017. I ended up having her on January the 20th of 2017. Now, the reason I did have her in Ohio, the reason I had a C-section with her was just because I didn't want to risk anything trying to do a vaginal, and why I had her early, was because my blood pressure was up for 3 weeks straight. So on my last doctor's appointment, I was supposed to have my C-section, because you schedule your C-section prior to your due date. So my due date was the 28th, my C-section was scheduled for the 24th. On the 20th, I had a doctor's appointment. And this is how you guys know that anything can happen, anything can change that quick. I was at my grandma's house doing my homework, trying to be a good student, and I had a doctor's appointment at 11. I went to my doctor's appointment. I told my grandma, I'll be right back. I left my homework up. I went to my doctor's appointment. My doctor said, no, I'm gonna send you over to labor and delivery and see what they say about this high blood pressure. So I'm like, okay. I went two times before that, so this is my third time going to labor and deliveries while I was pregnant with my daughter. And I'm just like, okay, like, we're about to go over here, and they're gonna have me sit here for 2-3 hours and then send me home, and then I'll be back on 24th to have my daughter. So my boyfriend had planned to go play basketball before work with his friends at 12. And I think he had to be at work at 4. So he called his friends like, hey, she gotta go to labor and delivery. Just give me like an hour or two and then we can go hoop. Yeah, we get over there and for some reason my veins do not like IVs. So it literally takes him 3 to 4 tries in order to get the IV to, you know, become stable so that they can draw blood and things like that. So she asked, did I want them to go ahead and stick me with the IV or wait until they determine if they're gonna keep me or not? So I'm like, no, go ahead and just go ahead and get the IV in there. So call my grandma, call my mom, let them know what's going on. I did not have contractions with my son. I had these pains in my stomach and everyone was saying, no, when you have a contraction, you're gonna know. You're gonna know, you're gonna know. Like, it's gonna be that bad. So I'm sitting in the doctor's office and there's a monitor where you can monitor your contractions. The needle kept going super high and come back down and like super, super low and then it shoots up. So I'm like, what is going on? She's like, you're having contractions. And I'm like, so for 2 weeks straight, I've been having contractions? And she was like, have you been feeling this pain? And I'm like, yes, like this is the pain I've been feeling. And I thought it was Braxton Hicks. She was like, oh no, those are the real thing. I'm surprised, you know, you had contractions that long. So I'm like, this is a contraction? Like, you guys, I am so extra. So I'm freaking out, like, this is a contraction. Like, oh my gosh. So my boyfriend's looking like, excuse me. So by this time, my grandma's come and the doctor on call was just like, we're just gonna go ahead and take her. It's pointless for us to send her back home just for her to come back in 4 days. Like, no, it's pointless. So my boyfriend's like walking around like, oh, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, I need some water. Yeah, it was the funniest thing ever. So we go back, they get me prepped. I do my spinal tap again. This time the spinal tap was super painless, super easy, super quick. Of course it happened right there with my legs getting numb from the waist down, get super numb. Now with this C-section, I did feel them pulling her out, and throughout the whole entire procedure, I really felt like I was just like non-existent. Like, I literally could not, it was like my body was there, but everything else was. I was there Friday. They released me on Monday night. They released me to go home, and then my best friend came and helped, you know, get everything together, settle everything. I packed my bag, I think, a week and a half before I had my daughter. So yeah, I wasn't really tripping. You know, once you get into the hang of things, your second child, you're literally like that commercial. First child, you extra. Second child, you chill. Third, extra chill. Like, you know, you start to get in the hang of things. So I believe that's all I wanted to talk about. Yeah. So as far as advice and things like that, sorry, my head itched. As far as advice and things like that, I do want to say, if you are currently pregnant, pack your bag at least 2 to 3 weeks prior to your due date, just because anything can happen. If you're already having complications and things like that, go ahead and pack your bag at that time. You want to pack your bag and you also want to pack your baby's bag. Don't bring any extraness. You want your essentials. So your toiletries, you know, like your toothbrush, deodorant, stuff like that. And then I brought my pillow because I take my pillow everywhere. So I took my pillow. So if you have something like that, a blanket or the little airplane pillows, bring that. And then as far as baby stuff, usually the hospital has diapers, wipes, onesies. So you won't need that, but still bring just a little bit. So an outfit, of course, to leave in, a few onesies, some diapers and some wipes, but just a little bit. You don't want to be, if you're having a C-section, to plan for it. Like I said before, I wouldn't watch any videos. Of course, you want to be knowledgeable about it, but I don't continuously watch videos over and over again, because their experience is not your experience. So I don't want you to get super, super nervous and then it's super easy. You know what I'm saying? So each person's experience is different. Of course, you know, become knowledgeable about the procedure just so that you know and you're aware. Also with the C-section, your recovery time is going to be a little longer. With my daughter, I was up and moving that night. Your girl was not keeping those little things on her leg because they itch. The medicine that they give you for the C-section, it's going to make you itch. I literally feel like I want to take my face off and my legs off. Like, it's going to itch. Sitting in the bed, I got butt sores with my daughter. So you want to make sure that you're up trying to walk, trying to, you know, work those stomach muscles and get back to that place where you're, you know, normal, you know, how you normally are. Also, for new moms, just make sure that you have the support and comfort that you need. I definitely was depressed after having both of my kids. I went through a depression stage. I went through a stage where I was just all over the place. So you want to make sure that you have a good support system. You want to make sure that you take time out for yourself when you need it, because you can't raise a baby if you're not functional, you know. So you definitely want to take the time out for yourself when you need it, and have somebody that you really care about there to support you, to help you with your baby. So that is all. If you have any questions about anything that I talked about in this video, definitely leave it down in the description box. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Sorry it's so long. I just wanted to give you guys full details and not leave much out. So definitely check out the rest of my videos. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. I love you guys. We're almost to 50 subscribers. That is a goal of mine. Halfway to 100. Love it. Thank you for all the support. I love you. Bye. I'm out.